You're watching Minity Maths. In this video, we are going to cover a variety of GCSE exam style questions. Links to the relevant topics will be provided above and in the description below. Subscribe and check out our other videos for more GCSE practice. Let's have a look at a typical GCSE style question about nets. This question provides four nets and asks you to identify the ones which show the nets of a cube. For this question, we can visualize how the net would fold up into a 3D shape. Let's start with shape A. Imagine this square was the base of the cube. These two squares could be folded upwards to form two sides of the cube. And this square could be the top. However, this square would overlap the one we already have at the top. And while this square would form the side, we would be missing the other side here. Try visualizing this same net using a different square as the base. You will always end up with overlapping squares and missing sides. Try to visualize the rest of these nets in a similar way and pause the video while you do this. Remember, there may be more than one way to fold these nets up. If you are finding this challenging, try using a piece of paper cut into the same shape as the net. So we can see that nets B and D are the ones which will form a cube. The question is worth 2 marks, and we would get 1 mark for each correct answer, but we would lose a mark if we circled an extra, incorrect answer. For this question, we are given 2 statements which must be true about the shape. The order must be 3 and there must be no lines of symmetry. Let's first concentrate on the lines of symmetry for each shape. This will help us to quickly rule out the shapes which cannot possibly be the answer. We can see that these 3 shapes have lines of symmetry, so we can rule these out. Now we are left with these 2 shapes. Let's test them both to see what order of rotational symmetry they have. We can see that this shape has an order of 3. We can also see that the other shape will not have an order of 3, as these triangles are facing different directions. Therefore, the correct shape is this one. For this question, we are given an equation. H equals 6k plus 4j. The first part of the question asks us to find the value of h when k is 2 and j is minus 5. We need to rewrite the equation with 2 in place of k, and minus 5 in place of j. We can then perform the multiplications, leaving us with 12 plus minus 20. Once we have performed the addition, we know that h is equal to minus 8. The second part of the question requires us to find the value of j. We are given values for k, as well as h. Firstly, rewrite the equation with the values substituted. We can perform the multiplication to simplify the equation. We now need to rearrange the equation in order to get the unknown variable j on its own. Firstly, we can take 4.2 away from both sides of the equation. This tells us that 20.8 is equal to 4 lots of j. To find out what 1j is equal to, we can divide 20.8 by 4, giving us an answer of 5.2. We are given the ages of a group of children and asked to find the mean, median, mode and range of these ages. For part 1, we need to find the mean. To do this, we add up all of the ages and divide by the number of children. We have 9 different ages here, so there are 9 children. If we divide 108 by 9, we get a mean age of 12. To work out the range, we need to find the difference between the highest age in the group, which is 15, and the lowest age, which is 10. To do this, we take 10 away from 15, and the answer is 5. To find the mode, we need to see which age occurs the most in the list. We can see that the ages 10 and 13 appear more than once. 10 occurs 3 times, while 13 only appears twice. Therefore, 10 is the mode. To find the median, we need to find the middle value in the list, once the list has been put in order. Here, the value of 12 is exactly halfway through the list. We can double-check this by counting the number of values on each side of the median. We are given 4 sub-questions to answer. These sorts of questions are usually worth 1 mark each. Question 1 asks us to simplify the expression b plus b plus b plus b. Here we have 4 lots of b's, which can also be written as 4b. This is now in its simplest form. The second question asks us to simplify a multiplied by itself 4 times. When we multiply a term by itself, we can use indices to show this in a simpler form. As we are multiplying a by itself 4 times, we can simply write a to the power of 4. For question 3, we are asked to simplify 7j plus 9j. These terms are the same, because the variables are both j, we can simply add these 2 terms together. We have 7 lots of j plus 9 lots of j, so in total we have 16 lots of j. We can write this as 16j in its simplest form. Question 4 asks us to multiply 5t by 3r. Even though these are not like terms, as the variables t and r are different, we can still multiply these together. Firstly, multiply the coefficients together, giving us 15. Multiplying t by r means we have t lots of r, which can be written as tr. We therefore have 15 lots of tr. We have successfully simplified all of the expressions. Thanks for watching, and good luck in your exams.